You're in tune to Story Untold. My name is PJ Nose, and I am proud to present
DaVido and the DaVidos. They're Metropolitan. DaVido and the DaVidos. So before you start to grin, just lend an ear and you will.
Metropolitan Theater is proud to present
DaVido
and the Libidos.
With the brand new album that just came out, about 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, a couple of weeks ago, right. And I want to let you know that I really love your show. I love the records that you spin. And it's kudos to you for keeping that music alive, man.
Well, you're doing your part, too, with this new album. It's called Metropolitan Theater, which is a perfect name for this album because it is impossible to categorize you into a genre. And we'll get into that in a few minutes. Something I wanted to ask you really quickly, though, because there was a voice on there that sounded very familiar. Who was that?
That was Uncle Cataldo, the Italian uncle who always wanted to be like a show business guy. He owned theaters. And we just had him announce. I thought his voice is very funny. And so we used him to do the little announcement. Just to let you know, that song is not on the downloadable version of the album, PJ. We are reserving that for when we cut this album in vinyl. There will be some tracks added to the vinyl version that aren't on the downloadable version.
Very cool. So those will be like collector's items. They're going to have exclusive tracks.
Absolutely.
For vinyl only.
Some hidden tracks, some bloopers, and just little things like that, you know. So we're excited about it.
Awesome. Well, I'm excited about the album. A lot of people are. Actually, John Fogerty from Clearance Clearwater Revival just retweeted your video to the masses, which is amazing.
Exciting.
So you're getting some big press, which is really crazy. And it's only been a grassroots effort with the new music video that you have out from the album. And
absolutely,
you're well over 1,000 hits already, and it's only been about a week.
You know, I want people to discover this on their own and not do this sort of synthetic push. You know, I want people to discover this and spread it around naturally, but that's when it really has some legs and some, you know, momentum, real momentum. As far as my video is concerned, I am very excited that we got 1,000 views in a week, and people are really jonesing to see this thing over and over again, you know. And if your listeners just go to runningeveryredlight.com/DaVido. You guys can see this video and see what I'm all about and what my music's all about.
And by the way to spell his name is DaVido. So it's like David O.
Right.
That's
right.
The easy way to remember it. The song is called Running Every Red Light. So if you hop on YouTube, you would be able to find it. And why don't we play the tune right now? Running Every Red Light by
DaVido and the Libidos, yeah.
Red DaVido, When the Libidos. That's a really nice a cappella ending there. And while we were listening to the song, you told me that a cappella ending was...
totally impromptu.
That's amazing.
Yeah, you know, what happened was the background singers were rehearsing that part for actually the meat of the song, the chorus. And I loved what they were doing, and I just told the engineer to keep the recording device going on, and I ran into the studio and just started singing with them. We did this whole thing, this whole a cappella thing, which we actually have a really long version of that, because I was just going crazy, and so were they. And then we cut that up for the Running Every Red Light record.
I want to hear that one day, that extended.
Oh, yeah, it's great, man. I love it.
Oh, that's awesome. And, you know, it's interesting because what you just mentioned reminds me of conversations that I've had with a lot of music producers from really the golden age of recording, the 40s, the 50s, the 60s, and so on, where a lot of stuff was impromptu. Like, I mean, It's In His Kiss by Betty Everett. They had somebody stomping on phone books, from what I've heard, and Motown used to do crazy things, and that's amazing that you did the same thing. You just were like, hey, these girls are sounding great. Just run the tape. Don't let them know that they're still being cut, and that's how you got that ending. And this is a really great record because there are no samples in here. This is all organic.
Nothing.
Why don't you talk a little bit about the recording process? Because it really is unique, being that this is a 2015 recording, the way that you put this whole thing together.
Right. Well, we'll let you know that we did use some of the modern technique, and that's WAV files, because we had so many tracks, PJ. It was ridiculous. We're talking hundreds of tracks on some of these records. That we wanted total separation, and we didn't have the luxury of having a whole orchestra at one time in the studio. Our studio couldn't even have the room for that at Retropolitan Studios. So we everything was vintage, though, as far as the microphones. We used the old Neumanns. The instruments were all real. Yeah, we have a song called Mr. Webster. Mm-hmm. Did you ever hear of a place called The Manor in West Orange?
Oh, yeah.
They have a real harpsichord. We went into that place one day with a recording, a mobile recording device, and we had our piano player, and he played Mr. Webster on a harpsichord, real harpsichord. We brought it into the studio and incorporated it in Mr. Webster. So if you hear the beginning of our song. So yeah, we used no samples, and that's where I wanted to make sure that I honored classic music in its best. Not that anything's wrong with samples. People do some amazing things with synthesizers, mm-hmm. But I personally wanted to honor the very essence of American rock and roll pop music and swing.
Well, you really did nail it. It's an amazing record, and we are going to get back into the record. That song, Mr. Webster, you just mentioned, is one that I would like to play. That's one that really caught me from this album. But before we do that, I have a little challenge for you. Now,
a challenge? Well, you want to arm wrestle me? You're a pretty big guy.
When you and I first met, I don't know, was it 10 years ago or however long it was, I saw you singing live, and I have to be honest, I was blown away. I mean, the type of voice that you have and the power that you have to not go flat and hit every note perfectly, it was amazing what I was seeing. I really can't describe it to this day. And I was thinking it would be really awesome if I had you sing here live in the studio with no effects or anything. This is just going to be right into that mic.
So are you telling me that you think that I may have an auto-tune on my voice when I record it?
No, I don't think that at all. As a matter of fact, I'm an audio engineer, and I usually have a good ear for those kind of things, and I don't hear any auto-tune. But a song that you sang the first night I saw you that really blew me away, I thought you did such a phenomenal job. I have a backing track for it right here, and I'd like to have you sing it. Are you cool? Is your voice good? Are you able to do this?
Oh, boy. How many people are going to be listening to this, would you guess?
Well, let's see. We're on 4 radio stations, and...
Never mind. I'm going to leave. I'll see you later. No, I certainly would love to try. What song are we talking about?
I Believe by Larry Chance and the Earls.
My God, it's so early to be doing that song. We wait till like 3 in the morning. No, I love that song, and I love Larry Chance. I love those guys. So, yeah, man.
All right, well, here on Story Untold, we're going to have DaVido, the lead singer of the Libidos, singing Larry Chance and the Earl's classic, I Believe.
Here we go.
Somewhere above, there is a heaven. Somewhere above, there is a star. Somewhere in the darkest night, a candle glows.
A candle glows.
I believe for everyone who goes astray, someone will come to show. The smallest prayer will still be heard.
Can still be heard.
I believe that someone in the great somewhere hears every
someone they love. Well, I could tell you, I lost someone very near to me. And yes, there were times that I lost hope. But somehow, somewhere, I knew that that light would shine again.
Yes, you did. DaVido, thank you so much, man. That was amazing.
Well, it's such a thrill to be able to sing live on your show, because you've got your audience are very sophisticated listeners. So I know they know that song in the original version and by Larry Chance and the Earls. And a lot of respect for that guy as a singer.
Absolutely. And I noticed that you had changed the spoken word middle a little bit.
I did. Well, you know, I lost somebody very near and dear to me, and I just did my own thing. That's all, just something as I felt it, you know. and I hope the audience doesn't mind.
No, not at all. I can speak, you know, from my own perspective. I didn't mind at all actually watching you sing it. I can tell you were coming from a place deep inside of you, and it was actually quite touching, and I hope it translated the same way over the air, but that was really an incredible performance, and I do appreciate it. And I also would like to just recap how people can get a hold of this album. It's DaVido and the Libidos. And how do they spell Libidos, by the way?
Yeah, right. I'm sure your audience is chuckling because people do when they hear Libido. And but I will say it's spelled L-I-B-E-A-T-O-S. So it's not Libido, although we are a high-octane band. It's more like Libito.
Libito. Well, that's very clever. Who came up with that? Was that you?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I did. I loved the rhyming with DaVido and Libidos. I always thought it had like this very cool retro, speaking of retro, feel to it, like DaVido and the Libidos. So I wanted to, and I just loved the name. And it's weird. It's retro, but it's also current.
It really is. Yeah, it's Retropolitan. It's the only way you can describe it.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Absolutely brilliant name for that album. It really does encapsulate what's going on here. It's retro, it's metropolitan, it's just a really cool album. Now, I Believe is not on the album. That's something that you just did here live on air, so I hope everybody enjoyed it. But there are some more great songs on the album, and we're going to be playing another song in just a moment. But I wanted to ask you before we get to that, so how long have you been singing, DaVido?
Oh, honestly, it's funny, my son, who you had on the air, and I appreciate you giving him his first break, he's just getting into singing, but I recall singing earlier than him.
Really?
I loved it. What a gift. What a gift it is to be able to sing. And I really consider it a privilege and an honor to sing. Certainly not something that I take for granted at all. I'm just happy that I'm able to do this and make somewhat of a living with it, you know.
Well, I hope people get an opportunity to see you live and in person, because absolutely it is something that I can tell you feel as a gift. You put so much energy, enthusiasm, and passion into your singing. And again, it just amazes me that every time I've seen you, and it's probably been about 6 or 7 times, you know, over these last 10 years that I've seen you, I mean, you never go flat, you never miss a note, you never miss a beat, and you're an extremely powerful singer, so I'm not really sure how you keep that up. I don't know what your mojo is. What kind of training did you have? Is this natural? Were you trained? Or?
I think a lot of guys that have these kind of voices, a lot of it is natural. And I've listened to great singers like Larry Chance. I love those kind of singers. Guys like Tom Jones.
Mm-hmm.
I love that powerful voice. All those kind of singers that you, a lot of the guys that you play, Mel Carter.
I love Mel Carter too.
I mean,
yeah.
What a voice. Those kind of singers. My mom played them. My mom was a singer. She was with the B. Wayne Singers. And my brother Jeff had a band called Jeff Kane and the Blue Flames. It rhymes.
That's cool.
Yeah. And so I just started listening to those guys, and I did study out in with a soprano, and because I have a real tenor voice. I'm not an opera singer, but God, do I love those opera guys! Oh
yeah,
my God,
yeah.
I listen
it's
to
intense
that.
Stuff, man.
Oh man, I love Andrea Bocelli and of course Pavarotti.
And I actually hear a little bit of that in your voice, too. I mean, you have a very powerful voice. And
thank you.
It takes you on this crazy journey during this album, and I hope everybody does get an opportunity to hear the album. How can they get a hold of it, by the way?
You know, incidentally, what I want to do is give your audience, as I mentioned before, a free download of my song, Running Every Red Light, which, you know, we have the video out, and as we talked about. And again, if you don't mind me mentioning it again, I'll spell it out for you. Just please go to your computer or phone and type in DaVido, DaVido, rocks, ROCK, .com, and you will get a free download of our single, which I'm really excited about. So please, audience and PJ's people and all this great doo-wop people, I'm hoping that you will make my song and my album the next phase of music that people listen to maybe 20 years from now.
Well, that would be awesome. And playing in the background right now is one of my favorite songs off of your album. It's called You Make Me Better, so let's cut into that. But again, DaVido is offering for the listeners of our show a free download of Running Every Red Light. So, you know, do feel free to take advantage of that, because it won't be free forever.
No, it won't. And I will say to you that if you get the free download, there will be an opportunity to buy the album from that download at a really, really discounted price. So everyone that does that will have the opportunity to do that as well.
Nice. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show.
It's such a pleasure, and I want to say thank you for keeping the doo-wop music and all the oldies alive. You're amazing, and thank you for giving my son an opportunity to be on the air.
Well, thank you, and let's give it full volume now. You Make Me Better. This is DaVido and the Libidos.
Yeah. Woo!